So, Replicas is a new sci-fi movie which takes a look at a world, the world of cloning. The plot concerns a neuroscientist played by Keanu Reeves, Canadian, who tries to bring his family back to life after a car accident. It comes out on Friday, and here's a wee bit of a preview.
Hey, Dad.
Morning, William.
Morning.
What's going on? William, something's not right with me. Tell me the truth.
There was a crash. You and the kids died.
Initiate.
I brought you back.
Wow.
That's good.
Alice Eve stars in the movie Replicas, and she joins us now. Welcome.
Thank you for having me.
Oh, man. So this is right up our alley. We love, like, these kind of dystopian films. You know, what attracted you to this role?
Well, first of all, Keanu Reeves. Obviously,
awesome.
You know, he's wonderful. But, you know, the idea of this cloning is something that we're coming up against as a culture, and the question of would you or wouldn't you if your loved one passed away and you were faced with this question, I think it would be really hard to say no.
Yeah.
Yeah. We've been running stories about, I think in China, you can clone
cloning,
your favorite
CRISPR,
pet.
Right? CRISPR
right?
Is a big
right. This guy
I've heard about
his puppy.
This, but apparently the personalities aren't the same. So the markings are the same and the look is the same, but then your pet maybe pees differently or doesn't lift his leg.
So keeping that in mind.
Right.
Playing a character that's cloned.
Yes.
Did you do a lot of research and you thought, okay, I'm going to play it kind of like a little different than what the original character would have been? Or
I felt that the best way to approach it would be to live in a sort of disassociative state, which I think we do now with our phones, and we always have another narrative running alongside us. But to imagine that you were constantly questioning yourself and suspicious of your surroundings, mm-hmm. which again is something I think we're trained to do in our culture of fear. And so it was like a sort of interesting way in of a real kind of example of that, that she was constantly like, I think something terrible is happening, and it is.
Right.
You know, Keanu Reeves, he's a producer on this film. For nerds like us, like me specifically, who followed his career, even going all the way back to Parenthood, which is like one of the early films that he did, to, of course, The Matrix. What's it like working with him? He's sort of a sci-fi legend for
totally.
Us.
Totally.
But I think he's a bit of a mystery, too.
Yeah, he definitely...
He's like a Buddhist monk type dude, right?
Yeah, like, he's like, he's very, keeps to himself, but, you know, as I got to know him better, and I'd say things like, oh, and da-da-da, but don't tell anyone this. And then he'd say, I'm a vault. And so after he told me he was a vault, I just like divulged my
vault.
Life story to him, you know. And so
we are
that.
Not vaults.
No. You guys chat?
We're blabbermouth.
We're such blabbermouths.
You can't blabbermouth in Hollywood.
The control room. Yeah, really?
Yeah, you got to keep your mouth firmly shut. So I was pretty comfortable telling him everything I knew about my life.
Oh, that's hilarious.
That's good. When are we going to get him on?
Yeah,
probably
right.
Never.
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 He's very, very tall.
So, you know, sort of ultimately, what do you want people to take away from this story? Is it a story? Is it a morality tale? Is it a love story? A guy who loves his family?
It's definitely a love story. I mean, there's definitely a very strong love story, and that's why he brings the family back, because he feels so much love for us.
Yeah.
And the relationship, the marriage was very strong. But I think the question, you want to come away from the film asking the question, would you or wouldn't you, and really kind of engaging in the debate. I always like a film that leaves you wanting to debate and question mm-hmm. things. And I think these are questions that are worth asking ourselves and working out our ethics on matters before they arise.
Mm-hmm. That's cool. Yeah. So you've got another project on the way. It's called Fair and Balanced. And
you
of course,
guys.
Huh? Yeah.
Yeah,
exactly. And it's about Fox News.
It's a newsroom, yeah.
It's a newsroom, and you're playing our pal Ainsley Earhart.
That's right.
So what was, give us, like, now that you see nerdy people like us and you see other journalists that you've talked to for this role, what was it like preparing for it?
Well, they sit down at Fox
yeah.
News.
And you guys some of us do. Look at Gail. She's sitting
yeah.
there.
Oh,
but
Gail,
like,
gets to
yeah,
sit.
Gail gets to sit.
You got a lot of nervous energy.
Yeah, you got to keep awake. But, you know, I learned a lot about the culture, and obviously it's very topical with Roger Ailes and the sexual allegations he had against him, and very different to the environment here. But that was what it was working with. It's Jay Roach, who did Game Change,
yeah.
who obviously, you know, enters that political conversation very astutely and has great observations to make. So it was a great thing to be on the set for, and I'm sure it'll be wonderful. You know, it's they have their Lucite desks.
Yeah, I saw a couple of stills yeah. from like some of the production shots, and they replicated like the Fox News News Corp building on 6th Avenue, mm-hmm. and that looks really like just like it does.
It probably looks better than it actually is. Usually these news
that is true. That
in real life, don't real, look
in,
as good.
In news, like in movies, like The Post or whatever, they sort of glamorize like the lives.
It's not glamorous to live. Yeah. I promise you, you're going into a building. There's no windows. You're walking and walking. You're like, where are we filming? Where are we filming? Right. You're in the deep depths of some building downtown. So, no, our life is your life is more glamorous. We're walking around in arcs, although I guess maybe.
It's so great to have you here. Thank you very much.
Thanks for having me.
Back when the movie comes out,
absolutely.
When Fair and Balanced comes out,
absolutely.
We'd love to talk to you about it.
That's
all right, cool.
Okay.
Alice,
Happy New Year.
Happy New Year to you.